This is our 3D printer. We use it to perform magical summoning rituals that summon 3D objects out of thin air.
Actually, Jay, it's kind of more like alchemy. Check it out. You take this and you turn it into this.
This is a dungeon tile. And we use them sometimes to create three-dimensional maps when we play like tabletop games like Dungeons and Dragons.
Yeah, we love them. They're crazy easy to make, even if you know next to nothing about 3D printing or painting.
Now, there are a lot of great videos out there that teach you all the immense detail about 3D printing, and there's even some YouTube channels that are dedicated to 3D printing gaming terrain like this. We are not 3D printing experts. We barely know how this thing works, and we're definitely not, you know, miniature painting experts either. But we do want to demystify this process for you and show you just how easy it is to make something like this.
You can make this. Yes, you!
Our first stop is a website called Thingiverse. This site has thousands of free 3D models contributed by some amazingly talented 3D artists. Everything on this website is free and can be 3D printed, and you can leave the creator a tip if you're able. In today's video, we're looking for the OpenForge 2.0 set, specifically the Cut Stone series by Devin Jones. Once we find the one we like, we just download the files. Once you've downloaded your 3D model, the next step is getting it ready for printing. We do this in an app called a slicer, and the one we're using is called CURA. This is also totally free. This is where we're gonna load in our 3D model from Thingiverse, and then there's tons of settings. We can look at how big it is, the level of detail, things like that, and that's gonna create a set of instructions for the 3D printer. Next, we let the magic happen. Clearly, this is magic, and it's completely amazing. Possibly also a time lapse. But let's just go with magic. As you can see, this particular tile has three parts, the base, the floor, and the wall. These come in separate pieces to give you more flexibility for mixing and matching different parts. All we have to do is use some super glue and glue them together. Once the glue is dry, next up is a coat of primer. We're just going to use a dark gray spray paint for this, and the dark color helps fill in the cracks and add some detail to the bricks. We're going to use three colors for painting these, a gray, a white, and a brown. We're specifically not mixing any colors because we want this to be easily repeatable later on. First, we're going to use a small detail brush, and we're picking a few bricks on each tile and painting them a light brown color. We want to pick randomly so that each tile is different, but we make sure to get at least one brick on the top and each side. And we usually give it two coats here. We don't know what order these tiles will be used in later when we play with them, so having a brick painted on each edge gives us plenty of flexibility. Once that's dry, we're going to use a bigger brush, and with a really light dab of the gray paint, we're going to sort of randomly blotch it a little at a time all over the entire piece. The trick to this part is not thinking about it too hard. We're going for rough, random, and fast. That way, each tile you paint will look different, and when you put them all together, it's going to have a great natural randomness to the look of the stone. The last step is dry brushing, and for this we're going to use a medium-sized brush with straighter, stiff bristles. The key to dry brushing is to take a tiny, tiny amount of paint and then wipe off almost all of it, and then very lightly drag the brush across the edges and the highlights. If you're interested more about these painting techniques, a quick search on YouTube for miniature painting is going to show you so many amazing videos. We highly recommend you go check those out. That being said, none of these techniques are difficult, and every single one of you could try this at home easily and create some awesome results. Looking at the three stages of the painting, you can see how each simple layer adds a lot of awesome detail. All in, a single one of these takes less than 5 minutes to paint and only costs about 20 cents in material. In this video, we simply covered the cut stone walls, but there's literally thousands of other things you can 3D print and paint. Also, if you're not into doing that, you can actually buy these online completely made for you and painted in high detail. Once you've printed a whole bunch of different stuff, you can imagine how fun it is to just hang out and build maps. Another thing that's fun to print and paint are these small detailed set pieces like tables, chairs, barrels, etc. If you'd like to see some videos on how we create and paint these, let us know in the comments.
This is Valera, the greatest paladin that has ever lived.
When we play these games, we use hand-drawn maps a lot. A lot of times we don't use any maps at all, and the games are just as fun. Either way, though, it's always an epic adventure.